Hello guys! Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Kung hindi ka pa nakasubscribe ay mag-subscribe ka na at i-hit mo na yung notification bell para updated ka sa ating mga accounting and taxation videos. Ngayon, we will discuss recording business transactions or mas kilala bilang process of journalizing. So sa last video natin, we identified the nature of transactions and their effect on the business enterprise na in-illustrate ko sa aking last video, which is yung debit and credit analysis. Kung hindi ka pa nakapanood nun, make sure lang na nakapanood ka muna nito or alam mo na yung debit and credit analysis before tayo mag-proceed sa ating next step. Balikan ko lang yung assets is equal to liabilities plus equity plus revenue minus expenses. Yun yung expanded form na ginamit ko the last time. Bago tayo mag-record, we must determine why do we record or ano yung role ng accounting records. So, accounting records have to maintain to enable the business entity to generate information that is summarized in financial statements. Mahalaga ang accounting records to establish accountability for the assets and or transactions under the individual control. Number two, mahalaga ang accounting records para meron tayong track of routine business activities such as the amounts of money in the bank accounts, amount due from credit customers, or amount owed to suppliers, okay? And number three, we must have an accounting record para maka-obtain tayo ng information about a particular transaction. And lastly, kailangan natin ng accounting records to evaluate the performance and the efficiency of various departments within the organization. So in recording business transaction, we must be able to identify the three elements. Number one is the accounts. Dapat alam natin yung accounts na ilalagay. Number two, we must be able to put or to record properly the debit. And lastly, the credit. So tatlo lang yan ha. ADC, okay? Account, debit, and credit. Minsan, may nilalagay silang tinatawag na chart of accounts. So, ano ba ang meaning ng chart of accounts? Ba't siya related sa word na accounts? Kasi, pag sinabing chart of accounts, it is a list of accounts in the ledger. That is called chart of accounts, okay? Nakalista yan in order in which they appear in financial statement from cash to equity to revenue and to expenses. Here is an example of chart of accounts, yung nasa screen natin ngayon. Ito yung example ng chart of accounts. Kung makikita mo, naka-pre-numbered sila, no? So mayroon silang flexible numbering system na ginagamit naman talaga even in actual practice. And then, bawat flexible number or unique number, meron siyang kaakibat na account. Example, yung cash, meron siyang unique number. Yung accounts receivable, meron siyang unique number. And so on and so forth. Okay? Yung gagamitin mo sa mga problems, yung pinapagamit sa yung mga accounts or allowed accounts. No? Hindi ka na pwedeng magbago or hindi ka na pwedeng mag-modify ng accounts na gagamitin mo except yung nasa chart of accounts. Tapos ka na sa meaning ng account, sa first element natin ng recording business transaction, punta naman tayo sa pangalawa at pangatlong element, which is the debit and credit. I-recap ko lang, the amount recorded on the left side of the account, if naka T account tayo, is called a debit entry. Likewise, any amount entered on the right side of the account is called credit entry. Debits and credits are sometimes abbreviated as DR for debit and CR for credit. Ulitin ko lang yung gamit natin dito sa pag-record ng business transaction is double entry bookkeeping. These are the rules for debits and credits which are designed so that the entry is recorded by equal peso amounts of debits and credits. This way in order for us to maintain the equality and condition of basic accounting equation, which is assets is equal to liabilities plus equity plus revenue minus expenses. Yung gagamitin natin sa pag-record ng journal entries for illustration purposes is yung T-account muna, and then after that we will show you how to record such transaction in the journal book. For example, Valix started business by depositing 50,000 of his personal funds in RAR's company bank account. I-analyze natin si Valix daw. Nag-start siya ng business by depositing 50,000. So if we analyze it, the asset cash is increased by 50,000 and the Valix capital or owner's equity is increased by same amount, 50,000. So sa debit and credit rules, we must increase an asset called cash. We must debit cash 50,000, and the other account is owner's equity. We must increase owner's equity, so we credit Valix capital for 50,000 pesos. Let's go to another example. On January 10th, we purchased repair tools and equipment 20,000 paying cash. So our analysis is we must increase an asset named tools and equipment for 20,000, and we must decrease an asset called cash for 20,000 din. Debit natin tools and equipment 20,000, and then we credit or babawasan natin yung cash worth 20,000. Sa entry sa T account natin, meron tayo sa left side na 50,000 kasi yun yung initial investment ni Sir Valix, and then we credit 20,000. Habang sa tools and equipment naman, meron tayong debit 20,000 sa left side of the account. Okay? So let's go to another example. On January 12, we purchased shop supplies 5,000 payable within 30 days. So our analysis is increase in asset, namely store supplies 5,000, and we must increase our liability, namely accounts payable 5,000 debt. So sa debit credit rules, we increase asset, we debit store supplies, and we increase our liability, we credit accounts payable. Sa entry sa journal accounts, meron tayong isang T account ng store supplies na mayroon siyang debit, or meron siyang amount sa left side which is amounting to 5,000. And we have also a T account on accounts payable that has a credit of 5,000. January 15 tayo, sold some of the tools at a price equal to the cost, 2,000 collectible within 10 days. Okay, so our analysis is we must increase asset, namely accounts receivable 2,000, and we decrease asset, namely tools and equipment, for 2,000 pesos. So our debit and credit rules is increase in asset, we debit accounts receivable, and we must decrease asset also, namely tools and equipment, so credit tools and equipment. If makikita mo sa ating ledger accounts or sa ating T account, merong accounts receivable na 2,000 nasa debit side siya, and then we have the tools and equipment T account na may balance na 20,000, tapos binawasan siya ng 2,000. No, so credit meron siyang 2,000 pesos. So let's move on to January 25. We received 2,000 cash representing collection of accounts receivable from the sale of the tools. So our analysis is increase an asset, cash 2,000, and when we decrease an asset, namely accounts receivable 2,000, kasi it is a collection of accounts receivable. So here is our debit and credit rules. So we must increase asset, we debit cash, and we must decrease asset, so we credit accounts receivable. Okay? So sa entry sa T account natin, if makikita natin yung T account, meron siyang 50,000 and then meron siyang deduction na 20,000, tapos may collection na naman siya na 2,000 pesos. How about your accounts receivable? Sa ating accounts receivable T account, meron siyang 2,000 na debit previously and then now we credit na the 2,000 pesos. At January 27 naman, we paid 2,000 in partial settlement of an accounts payable. So our analysis, ulitin ko, analysis muna tayo before tayo mag debit and credit rules, okay? So analysis, decrease in asset, cash 2,000, and then we decrease our liability kasi nagbayad tayo. We decrease our liability, namely accounts payable, 2,000 pa din. So punta naman tayo sa debit and credit rules sa January 27 na transaction. So decrease in asset, you will credit cash, and then decrease in liability, we debit accounts payable. Titignan ulit natin sa entries ng T account, sa cash, apat na yung transaction niya. Kaya, meron siyang debit na 50,000, meron siyang debit na 2,000, meron siyang credit na 20,000, and ngayon-ngayon lang, kredetan natin ng 2,000 na credit. Okay? Well, sa accounts payable, if you can see, meron tayong balance na 5,000 sa credit and then binawasan natin siya by debiting 2,000 sa debit or sa left side of the T account. January 31, we recorded 7,000 sales of repair services received in cash. So, naka-render tayo ng services through cash. So, our analysis is we increase an asset, specifically cash 7,000, and then we increase our owner's equity or service revenue by 7,000 pesos. So our debit and credit rules, is we must increase asset, we debit cash, and then we must increase owner's equity, we credit service revenue. Okay? And then if titignan na ulit natin sa ledger accounts, meron na tayong limang transaction sa cash. Ito na yung 50,000 debit, 2,000 debit, at ngayon-ngayon lang nag-debit din tayo ng 7,000. And then may credit siya na 20,000 noong January 10, and meron din siyang credit na 2,000 noong January 27.